video class. That was power sharing. What do you mean by power sharing? Power sharing is distribution of powers from the higher authorities to the lower authorities so that the work can be done in a chronological and a proper way. एक तरीके से काम हो सके, इसलिए हम अपनी powers को, जो higher authorities होती हैं, वो अपनी powers को क्या करती हैं? Decentralize करती हैं, loose up करती हैं, लोगों को उसमें involve करती हैं, जिससे जो local people की problems हैं, उनको sort out किया जा सके. That is a power sharing. You have studied about the two examples. दो states का example आपने देखा था. One was Belgium and one was Sri Lanka. In Belgium, you have seen that the people, the higher authorities, the government has made different kind of communities. कुछ community governments उन्होंने बनाई, कुछ उन्होंने हर religion को, हर language को importance देके उन्होंने एक ऐसा system startup किया जिससे हर जना satisfied था उनकी country में. In the next example in Sri Lanka, you have seen that the people has given the powers to the majority of the people, majority section ko. There was a contrast in that particular section, and because of that, the people were facing problems, the minorities were facing the problems, and they were not able to solve up and show, or they can, you can call it off, wo apni problem ko bata nahi pa rahe the government ke officials ko. So to avoid this problem, what is the solution? Solution is to divide the power, to decentralize the power, or you can call it out power sharing. Now, this power sharing is to be done in properly specified hai. So they are having a guarantee. Okay? They have specific matters of legislation, taxation and administration. Jurisdiction mein bahut sari cheeze included hoti hai. The all working, the complete management is included. So us management ke andar, for example, they have given the legislation means the making of the laws. Second, taxation, the complete taxation department. And the administration of that particular area where the power or the where the jurisdiction is working. Fourth one, for any kind of changes in the constitution, consent of both the levels, means central level and state level, are required. For any kind of change, for any kind of new law, both the departments, both the levels should be agreed on it. अगर किसी एक डिपार्टमेंट को भी प्रॉब्लम होती है तो वो हम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में इंक्लूड नहीं करते हैं. दैट बिकम्स अ टॉपिक फॉर द डिबेट. ओके, द फिफ्थ वन इज द कोर्ट्स हैव पावर टू इंटरप्रेट इन द पावर्स ऑफ डिफरेंट लेवल्स. कोर्ट्स दैट इज सुप्रीम कोर्ट और द हाई कोर्ट और द वी कैन कॉल आउट जुडिशियल सेक्शन. उस कोर्ट को ये पावर है कि अगर कोई भी लेवल, दोनों लेवल अपनी पावर्स का मिसयूज कर रहे हैं तो देन दे हैव अ राइट टू इंटरफेयर इन बिटवीन. ओके, एंड मेक अ करेक्ट डिसीजन लाइक एन एम्पायर. ओके, इन अ क्रिकेट मैच. द थर्ड नॉन सिक्स वन इज डुअल ऑब्जेक्टिव. व्हाट इज द डुअल ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ अ ज्यूरिसडिक्शन? दिस इज अ वन काइंड ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चन व्हिच आई एम टेलिंग यू इन द वीडियो इटसेल्फ. व्हाट इज अ डुअल ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ अ ज्यूरिसडिक्शन? The dual objective of jurisdiction are first to safeguard and promote the unity of the country. Country ki unity ko promote karna plus usko bacha ke rakhna, safeguard karke rakhna. This is the first motive. Second, to accommodate the regional diversity. You know that India is that kind of place where the number of people are living and everybody is belonging to the different regional diversity. Their regions are different, their languages are different. So everybody should get the equal right and importance. This is the main objective of jurisdiction, that nobody should be revealed or koi bhi jana apne rights ko use karne se piche nahi reh jaye. Ye hamara main motive hota hai jab bhi hum jurisdiction ko form karte hain. Okay, next topic we are going to study about coming together and holding together federation. These are the two types of federations.
There are two types of federations. One is coming together federation and another is holding together federation. In coming together federation, under this, independent states come together on their own to form a bigger unit. इस वाली federation के अंदर जितने भी independent states हैं ये अपने आप को इंडिविजुअल बनाने की, इंडिविजुअल करने की कोशिश करने की पूरी तरीके से, दे ट्राई देयर बेस्ट टू मेक देमसेल्व्स अ बिगर यूनिट. ओके, एंड व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट होल्डिंग टुगेदर फेडरेशन, अंडर दिस अ लार्ज कंट्री डिसाइड्स टू डिवाइड इट्स पावर बिटवीन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट स्टेट्स एंड द नेशनल गवर्नमेंट. When we talk about holding together federation, at this time and this type of federation, what happens that the country is divided and it divides its power into two forms, like in national and in state government, and it decentralizes its power. Let's come back to coming together federation again. Under this, all the states usually have equal powers, like all the states, they are having their own identity. Like if I talk about USA, so every citizens belonging to USA, those people are having their own nationality. Like if we talk about India, अगर मैं इंडिया की बात करूँ तो हम सबका, चाहे हम किसी भी स्टेट में रहें, we belong to one nationality, that is Indian. But this is not happening in the other countries like in USA, Switzerland and Australia. Everybody is having two nationalities, that they are belonging to one state and one country. So they are having two nationalities over there. But this is not happening in holding together federation. Under holding together federation, central government tends to be more powerful. Ye aapko pata hai ki hamari state government se zyada central government powerful hai. Okay, Like now there is an example, coming together federation, there are three types of countries. Example is given over here, that is USA, Switzerland and Australia. And in holding together federation, three examples again are given, that is India, Spain and Belgium. Now, what makes India a federal country? We have seen earlier that how small countries like Belgium and Sri Lanka face so many problems for managing diversity. Then if these small countries are facing problems, then what about India? India is such a vast country with so many languages, religions, regions, etc. What are the power sharing arrangements in our country? You know that India had emerged as an independent nation after a painful partition. Soon after independence, several princely states became a part of the country. The constitution declared India as a union of states. Although they were not using the word federation, but the Indian Union or Indian central government was based on the principles of federation. The constitution originally provided for the two-tier system of the government, union government, or you can call it of central government, which is representing the center or the Union of India, and the second one was state government. Later, after some time, the third tier system was included in the federalism in a form of panchayat and municipalities. These different tiers enjoy separate jurisdiction. The constitution clearly provided the threefold distribution of legislative powers between union government and state government. Thus, it contained three lists, which includes different regions of jurisdiction. The three lists are union list, state list, and concurrent list. Union list includes subjects of national importance, such as defense of the country, foreign affairs, banking, communication, and currency. The union government alone can make laws relating to the subject mentioned in the union list. Now, let's move forward to the state list. State list contains subjects of state and local importance, such as police, trade, commerce, agriculture, and irrigation. The state government alone can make laws relating to the subjects mentioned in the state list. The third one is concurrent list. This list includes subject of common interest to both the union government as well as to the state government. इसके अंदर इस लिस्ट में हम दोनों डिपार्टमेंट्स की चीज़ों को इंक्लूड करते हैं, लाइक एजुकेशन, फॉरेस्ट, ट्रेड यूनियंस, मैरिज, अडॉप्शन एंड सक्सेशन. Both the union as well as the state government can make laws on the subject mentioned in this list. If their laws conflict with each other, the laws made up by the union government will prevail. That means कि अगर इन दोनों जगहों के यानी यूनियन के और स्टेट के लॉज में कुछ कन्फ्यूजन होता है या कुछ कंट्रास्ट होता है, तो यूनियन गवर्नमेंट के लॉज को ही प्रायोरिटी पे रखा जाता है एंड दे परफॉर्म इन दैट मैनर. एम आई क्लियर? ओके. वी नोटेड अबव दैट मोस्ट फेडरेशंस दैट आर फॉर्मड बाय होल्डिंग टुगेदर डू नॉट गिव इक्वल पावर टू इट्स कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट यूनिट्स. दस ऑल स्टेट्स इन द इंडियन यूनियन यानी कि इंडियन सेंटर डू नॉट हैव आइडेंटिकल पावर्स, मीन्स सिमिलर पावर्स. Some states enjoy a special status. For example, Jammu and Kashmir has its own constitution. Many provinces, provisions of Indian constitutions are not applicable of this state without the approval of
state assembly. Indians who are not permanent residents of this state cannot buy land or house here. Similar special provisions exist for the some other states of India as well. As you know, this is the old book and now there is a changes in the Indian constitution. Jammu and Kashmir is now the part of India completely, so all the rules and regulations are applicable over there also. But earlier, we are talking about earlier this in this book, earlier we were not having the right in the Jammu and Kashmir properly actually, and the people were not allowed to take the land or purchase the house over there, okay, because of the certain rules and regulations, okay. So in the same way, there are some units of Indian Union which enjoy very little power. These are areas which are too small to become an independent state, but which could not be merged with any of the existing states, like Chandigarh, Lakshadweep, or the capital city of Delhi, are called Union Territories. These territories do not have powers of state. The central government has special powers in running these areas. This sharing of power between the union government and state government is basic to the structure of constitution. ये इतना easy नहीं होता कि हम power sharing में changes easily कर सकें. Parliament on its own cannot change this arrangement. Any change to it has to be first passed by both the houses of पार्लियामेंट विथ एटलीस्ट टू थर्ड मेजॉरिटी. अगर हमें कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में कोई भी चेंजेस करने हैं तो उसकी पार्लियामेंट की रजामंदी होना बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है. बोथ द हाउसेज शुड गेट अग्रीड टू इट एंड विद द टू थर्ड ऑफ मेजॉरिटी, मीन्स टू थर्ड पीपल शुड गॉट एग्री ऑन दिस. देन इट हैज़ टू बी रेटिफाइड बाय द लेजिस्लेचर्स ऑफ लीस्ट हाफ ऑफ द टोटल स्टेट्स. The judiciary plays an important role in overseeing the implementation of constitutional provisions and procedure. In case any dispute about the division of power, the High Court and Supreme Court make a decision. The union and state governments have the power to raise resources by levying taxes in order to carry on the government and the responsibilities assigned to each of them.